weekend in Misano. It was the third closest top 15 we've had at a full-length Premier Class. Misano. Clash of the Titans in MotoGP. Closer than ever.
Yes.
Away he's into turn one.
Good start as well by Pecco Bagnaia. He's picked off Pol Espargaró straight away. So Bagnaia into four, between turns two and three. And Vinales goes on the inside of Miller into the fourth corner. Vinales then from... Mir was wide into turn five on the factory Suzuki as he tries to make headway from 11th place. Inside of Fabio Quartararo. Oh, does he? It was tight, very, very tight. Really tight. Oh, well, that's one of the kids. Certainly one of the inflits. And I think Morbidelli's now last. Binder goes up the inside of Pol Espargaró into turn 10. No repeat of iterates from last weekend. Alexis Espargaró down and out on lap one at turn eight. Although he's back on that valley break here. Bagnaia has made the move stick finally on Fabio Quartararo then. He's up in the third. It was Morbidelli in his lap. He said yesterday he felt like they've made a step forward. It looks like it is so far. He leads. Good for Army. Was he caught to play? Step with Alexis Espargaró, Franco Morbidelli right now, and Jack Miller. This is the sort of thing that Esteban Garcia wanted to... For Valentino Rossi! Not the way that he wanted to celebrate his 250th Grand Prix appearance for the faction heartache for Rossi one weekend ago when he got picked for the podium by Mir. There's early heartache today for Rossi. Positions, he's up to third, and Alexis Espargaró is heartbroken. He cannot believe it, cannot believe it. And here comes Pecco Bagnaia then. He's a second down on Maverick Vinales. Got loads of time to bridge that gap. Watch Rossi to Pol Espargaró and Fabio Quartararo. Oh, Binder's gone down! Binder's gone down now, turn 15! Eight, Rossi down, back up. Binder down, is he back up? Across the line we go then. Vinales and Raro in third place. Danilo Petrucci is up in the top six. Giovanni is now seventh. Lecomo is about to unfold in the next 25 laps or so here. So Rossi out and back. Remo, Raro early on as well for Franco Morbidelli. Let's try and catch up. Bagnaia's made good progress. Is it? Well, this is a different ball game as well. He's never been in this position. He's never led for this long. Moto, but this is a completely different ball game. All together, you can see that above your screen. So maintain that pace right now. Every single position and point is golden.
Yeah. Any news on Jack from pit lane time?
Stand at the moment, locked on points, Fabio Quartararo and Dobby would be going into the heat, hold off Maverick Vinales. That gap has just creeped back up to 0.9 seconds again. Pol Espargaró also looks like he's just about able to hold off Quartararo at the moment. The pace is just incredible. The guys in qualifying is just so crucial these days in MotoGP. What happened to Dobby? Just got swallowed up somewhere in sector one as well. Jack Miller's retired from the race. This is your race leader, Pecco Bagnaia, on the Pramac. But Maverick Vinales, is that it now? Is this his chance to break free? It says go for it. Struggling a bit here. Giovanni Mir's closing in on the Frenchman is one thing. That's a completely different matter. Itaka Nakagami has not been able to find a way through as yet. You're looking here on board with Fantasy's four. Obviously the podium for silverware, but for another few precious points as well, which would mean Quartararo without a podium, it will be unless he reels in Pol Espargaró ahead of him. It's definitely coming down that gap. It's Bottas, goodness me, I apologise to viewers at home. Transponders here this weekend, I'll tell you what, away. I hate transponders, I hate Pol Espargaró. It's quite anti-tasticus on that last lap. Quartararo was punched the quicker man by 3 laps on it. He hasn't got a lot of information on it. At this stage of race, this will be the stage of race where they'll come down by a few tenths. Maverick Vinales now 1.1 down. This is the fight for third between Pol Espargaró. Sound like a lot in MotoGP, but these 3 points that Quartararo is trying to fight for right now when it's so tight. 11. Fabio Quartararo is so much speed through those fast right-handers. Is he closing? He's closing. He's closing. He's not going to do it on this lap. He stays in fourth. Look at that little wear. Side to side, that's for sure. Excessive wear there. Look, it looked like the right choice to go for the soft. He's got a long, long way.
way to defend here against the charging Quartararo. Well, Fabio doesn't need to do anything silly. Found a way through on Andrea Dovizioso. He's on his way to another top 10. Dovizioso has pushed the count in the lead here of his home Grand Prix. Can you believe it? And the GP World Championship is abject frustration for Pecco Bagnaia. He was over a second clear. He questioned whether or not that pace could be maintained for a full race distance. And that's a hard one to call. Might have to get some disappointing, but that Pecco Bagnaia will take him as well. What a stunning late charge again. Must be racing Vinales right now. 100%. Through the left hander we go. He's got four. The advantage for him is the top speed, because Fabio's finding it really tough, and he's going to have a face full of guys, both in the top eight. Absolutely awesome. Andrea Dovizioso, it's not a bonus that really, you've got to say, based on what we've seen so far from him, he doesn't really deserve it. He's weighing up a move. It's got to come here. It's his best chance through turn 14, but he doesn't. Well, they've deserved it, because Quartararo and Mir, they're just ganging up right behind him. To do it here into turn one. Is he close enough? Is he close enough? Oh, he just can't get any drive, Thomas Bagnaia. He's waited all this time, Fabio, to try and go through on Thomas Bagnaia. Joan Mir might try and take two in one. That's like last weekend. Each perfect, ruthless move to dispose of the Italian. He's doing it now to Fabio Quartararo as well. On the brakes into turn number eight. Brilliant braking move though by Thomas Bagnaia. How strong is he on that front row defensive? Mir's coming through anyway. He's going to have a good look. Thomas Bagnaia, oh no. He saw. Got two and a bit laps left. He's 4.7 clear. It's enough here. He likes that flip-flop, doesn't he, between turns one and two. He made a lot of moves there last weekend. Keep the same manoeuvre on Thomas Bagnaia. Just going to get the drive now out of this final quarter to make sure he's close. Still, pole holds on. Here comes Mir, though. Up the inside into turn one. Can he make it stick? Yes, he can. Here, Quartararo pounces on him at turn three. Corona's name's dropped down the time script. Corona was off for a stunning, stunning ride, but he's crashed out with two laps to go. Andrea Dovizioso, pet night, wasn't he? There is La Corona. He's down, let's hope he's okay. Just look at the rhythm, the blinker and eye. Absolutely incredible late race speed again from the Suzuki man. The Vinales count that can barely watch. Maverick Vinales, really, really would. The confidence this is going to give him, this one. And look at Franco Morbidelli as well. The guy should be in bed. He shouldn't even be out there. He's gone through on the team. Fabio Quartararo has just come up on our screen. He's got to take the long lap penalty. The stories, dude. He was given the track limits evening. But the world championship leader then, he might not be the world championship leader now. After Maverick Vinales then, has just got a few kilometres left. It's been pure drama, pure 30 yet again of Thomas Bagnaia. We saw how dirty it was on the long lap loop in Moto3. Now, has he seen it on his dashboard? Is he going to take the penalty loop? No. He takes to come through the long lap penalty loop onto his time, and that's going to cost him the podium. In the meantime, I hold my hand up and thought, I've lost a bit of faith here. Well, he has proven a lot of people wrong. He's going to be another new race winner. It's been incredible. 27 laps here. Pure drama. The flag is out. The Gremlins are gone. Mack is back again. He wins here in Misano. Mir to championship. We'll find out shortly. But where do you begin to analyse this tie? Another new winner. Our sixth different winner in seven MotoGP races in the commentary box. Unbelievable rise. Maverick Vinales takes the victory after heartache for Pecco Bagnaia. Quartararo, well, he took the checkered flag third, but he's going to be off the podium. KTM know it. And in some ways, he probably deserved it, having ridden so brilliantly on that soft rear tyre. Outstanding now. Get the reaction from him. He must be delighted to see number 12 back on the top step.
Mario, just shut up. What do you think of his run?
Exactly. I couldn't wait for it. We did the poll yesterday, we did the poll last week, and we couldn't anyway, I think, achieve what the host did. It come down to work in the garage that we were watching on Saturday. We had basically, you could feel the bike with the same feeling and behavior that he had during the race. That here it worked.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations to Maya Marigali. Thank you for something incredible, sensational, phenomenal MotoGP race we've had.